Hi everybody, my name is Jordan and I'm a children's librarian at Soldier Regional Branch of the Chicago Public Library. Have you ever been interested in 3D printing? And are you looking to design some practical and unique prints? Well, you can use free 3D modeling programs like TinkerCad, which is what you should see on the screen in front of you, to create and design customizable practical prints. Today, we are going to build a fidget cube together. Right, and to get started, you should be able to see TinkerCAD on your screen. We have our blue gridded work plane and nothing on it, which is great. That's a good place to start. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to drag a shape from the right-hand side of the screen where it says TinkerCAD basic shapes. You see a red box shape, a cube. I'm going to drag that to my work plane. Perfect. And I'm going to change the size of this cube. 20 millimeters by 20 millimeters would probably be okay to fit in your pocket, but it's a little bit hard of a space to work on, so we're going to make this bigger. And we will just double it to 40. And you see, I'm just clicking on the white squares to change the dimensions of my cube. You can type the numbers in, which is what I just did. You can also use your mouse to reshape the cube to be a size that you think would be appropriate to work on. And you'll be able to resize it later at the end. So don't worry too much if it looks like it's too big or it won't fit in your pocket. That's okay. Okay, so we're just going to add different shapes to each side of this cube to make a little toy. If you've never played with a fidget cube before, it's just a little toy that you can play with while you're focusing on a screen or while you're working on something that can kind of keep your hands busy while you are needing to focus. It actually comes in handy for me quite a bit. They're pretty fun to play with. The first thing I'm going to do with this cube, because I do want it to be something that could potentially, easily fit in a pocket, I'm going to round the edges a little bit. And you can do that by using the radius tool. You can see on the right-hand side, when I put down my shape, we got this little shape pop-up box that can change different parts of the shape. Right now, we're going to change the corners to be a little bit more rounded, and you can use the button to sort of play with it. You see that if we go too far, it turns into a perfect sphere. We're gonna actually set this to 3. Perfect. That looks good to me. You can see, if you see in the top left-hand corner, you can see the box that tells you what perspective you are looking at your object from. I play with it quite a bit. I find it really helpful to see things from all sides. I encourage you to play with it as well. It's nice to see, to kind of get an idea of what your print will look like from every direction. And sometimes you might notice that you'd like to change some things after looking at it. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to add sort of like a bumpy surface to the top of our cube. And to do that, I'm going to use this work plane tool to the right of the screen, and I'm going to drag it to the top of my cube, and that's going to change the work plane, which is like if you're working on a table, right? That would be the tabletop. So it's going to change where the tabletop is, so that you can set your shapes directly on top of the cube instead of having to fiddle around with it. So I'm going to drag a sphere shape over to the top of my cube. And I'm going to resize it. A cool trick for resizing shapes is you can actually hold down the shift button and change one dimension with your mouse and it will change everything. You also can do what I did earlier by changing it using the number pad on your computer or laptop. But I like that, that looks good. I changed it to 6 millimeters on all sides. So it is a perfect sphere. And now I want this to be in the center of my cube. And to do that, I'm going to select both shapes. You can do that by just drawing a rectangle and grabbing both shapes, you also can use the shift button and click on both shapes. To make sure that you have selected them, you can look up here, you see where it says shapes two, that means that I have two shapes in my selection. That's a good way to check yourself to make sure you've gotten everything in that you want. And then my align tool is up here, top right-hand corner of the screen. It's got sort of two different size rectangles and a vertical line to the left of it. And that is going to make it so that we can align our sphere vertically and horizontally. So now it's directly in the middle of our surface. Perfect. And then one thing I'm going to do before we add more spheres is I'm going to change my snap over here. I'm going to snap the grid to 2 millimeters instead of 1. Okay. So I've got one shape, I've got one sphere. I'm gonna recreate this pattern, actually recreate the shape in a pattern on the top of my cube. So I'm going to click it and I'm going to duplicate it. This button will duplicate exactly the shape that you have selected, which is kind of nice. So I'm gonna use my arrow keys to move that over to where I think it would work, where I'd like it. And I'm going to do the same thing over here so that I have little row, it looks like a die kind of, right? I got 3 in a row, perfect. And then I now want to group these so that I can easily add 3 more. And again, I'm gonna double check my work and make sure that it says I've got 3 shapes selected. It does, which is a good sign. And I'm gonna use my grouping tool. That is the shape that looks like a square and that is kind of being eaten by a circle. So click on that and perfect. Now I've got all 3 of these spheres grouped and I'm going to duplicate them again. So same button on the top left-hand corner, duplicate and repeat. I'm gonna move and copy up. And I'm going to duplicate it again. I'm gonna move a row down. And that looks pretty good to me. So right now I've got 9 little spheres sitting on top of the cube. Perfectly handy. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm actually gonna group all of these together. I don't have them all though. Just my spheres, not the cube. So I'm going to use my shift button to click them all and make sure I have 3 shapes. I know it looks like there are 9 spheres, but since I grouped them, I have 3 groupings in my selection now. And I'm going to group those 3 groupings so that I can embed all 9 of these spheres into the surface of my cube at the same time. Perfect. So there is one side done. And then this is totally customizable, right? So you can add whatever shape you'd like to each side of your cube. You can play around with it. You can think about what you would like to sort of feel when you're playing with a cube. I know that I really like a nice indentation where I can fit my thumb in. So actually that's what I'm going to do next. I'm gonna take my work plan tool and I'm gonna work on, take my work plan tool and I'm gonna work on the space of my cube. Perfect. And I'm going to make a sphere-shaped, spherical indentation. And I like to see, you can see I did not get that on my cube. I like to see it from every angle. So apologize for my often moving screen. That looks good. Okay, I'm going to center this on my cube. And I just want to center it with the cube, but not the sphere shape. So I'm going to hit shift and click my sphere and then hit shift and my cube. It says I have 2 shapes, which is right to me. I'm going to make a hole. Let's see, I lost it, sorry. I'm going to align it to the center. Oh, it's already in the center, perfect. And you know, looking at it now, I actually want it to be a little bit bigger. So let's change that. Let's make it 28 on all sides. Okay, that looks better. I've got a very, I had a big thumb. I want a lot of room to play with, right? So let me go back to selecting and aligning. Shift, holding down the shift key, getting my align tool, aligning in both planes. That looks great. Now I've got like a goofy little sphere hanging off of a cube. I'm going to change that. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to make this a whole, my sphere a whole shape. So that when I embed it into the cube, instead of having like these raised bumps, I'm going to have a nice little hole. So put that in 8. Seems okay. Maybe a little bit less. How about 6? Okay. That looks perfect. Okay. Let's focus on our next side. So I'm going to drag my work plane over to another side of my cube. And now we can use, we'll do the roof shape. The rounded roof shape, I should say, which is just like a little semicircle. I'm gonna make this just a little bit longer. Looks good. Let's make it maybe a little bit longer, like 26 millimeters. And we'll make this a little bit thinner. We're gonna make a series of ridges. So we'll make this 6 millimeters maybe. And the last thing I want to do is make sure, see, it's another, it's going out very far, right? So I want to make sure this is shorter, 3 millimeters. Okay, perfect. That looks good to me. Okay, so this one, let me center it first. I'm going to center it. And again, I'm selecting my cube and my rounded roof and nothing else, because those are the only shapes that I want. Using my align tool, center it vertically and horizontally on my plane. And then I'm going to copy this. And it's just gonna duplicate the shape exactly. I'm going to copy this again. That looks good to me. I've got 3 little ridges to play with on one side now. And now on this side, I'm going to drag my work plane over for me. There you go. And I'm going to use my torus shape. So I'll pull it over here. And this will give you kind of similar to the sphere, right? An indentation to play with, but it's a round indentation. And then you see how you can see the red in the middle. And that will end up being like a raised part. So it's kind of like a circle for your finger to follow. And you could do the same thing or something similar with like a maze shape if you wanted to use a series of rectangle of cubes. You could do it that way. All you're doing is sort of figuring out what kind of shape you want the hole on this side of your fidget cube to look like. So this I want to be a little bit bigger on each side. And I'm going to do the same thing where I center it. So I am holding shift and selecting the objects I want to align, aligning on both sides. And I'm gonna make this a whole shape. And I'm going to sink it into my piece. Perfect. And that just gives me a fun little circle to follow with my fingers, right? All right, we have 2 more sides. I'm gonna leave the bottom empty because when we print it, I want it to print flat. I think it'll be easier. But let's try a different shape. And you could do a star shape, maybe if you would like to trace a star, or you could do a letter if you wanted to trace maybe like, you know, your initials or something. I'm going to show you what it looks like with the roof shape because it's got a nice texture. It'll give you like some bumpier, higher ridges to play with, if that is your thing. And I think I'm just gonna do, let's see, I'll change this to be maybe 8x8. And that looks good, okay. And then I'm going to change the height of this because look how far it sticks out. I don't want that in my pocket. I'm gonna maybe lower that out. Maybe let's just do like a 4. That looks good, okay. So I'm going to copy this shape and move it on my fidget cube. I think it would be more fun if these were close together, actually. So I'm going to move them just inward a little bit. We'll see how that comes out. Let me make sure that looks centered. Okay, perfect. So we've added something to all sides of our fidget cube. We're almost done. The last thing I'm going to do is I'm going to put my work plane back on the bottom so I can see it. And I'm going to group this whole shape together. You can use your selection tool, right, where you click down and draw a square, or you can hold shift and select each shape one by one. And you can use your grouping tool in the top right-hand corner to group it. And you can tell when it's grouped because everything changes to the same color, which is great. Very handy. And then if you want to make this smaller right now, this will print, it'll be about the size of a golf ball, a little bit bigger than a golf ball, which is pretty hefty for something that you're going to put in your pocket. If you want something smaller, you can adjust the size by holding shift so that the each size changes up proportionately and dragging the top square down to a size, and you can see the size changing right on the right, to a size that would be maybe smaller if you want something smaller. I'm gonna leave mine pretty big though because I think it'll be more fun that way. Cool. 40. Okay, perfect. So congratulations, you did it. Please customize this as you would like. You can use any shape for any side, play around with it. It's pretty fun. They're pretty fun to play with once you print them. And if you do build a fidget cube, please don't forget to share it and submit your design to have it printed out at one of our pickup locations. We have a select number of branches where we will print your 3D printed objects for you, and you can come and pick it up. If you need more assistance, please check out our website at www.jpublib.org and register for one of our online workshops. And you can see, sometimes you can see a 3D printing demonstration or get hands-on practice and helpful suggestions for how to use TinkerCad. And you can also watch other TinkerCad video tutorials and view step-by-steps and how to create one of our other practical print designs. We'll see you next time. Take care.